So we're going to be washing Newport today. It's been several weeks since his last bath, about a month actually, and living in the desert, he has been getting super dusty, and it is well time for him to have a bath. Now, in between having his bath, he certainly gets brushed, which is going to help reduce the number of times that you need to bathe your dog, which is excellent because you don't want to constantly be giving your dog a bath. Because, well, that's going to dry out their coat because it's going to be removing oils from it. So let's get Newport on up into the bath. Newport, jump. That's it. Climb. Yeah, climb. Come on. That's it. That's it. There we go. What a good climb. Good boy. So the kind of interesting thing about the bath is here, at least where we live, we have this crazy like car wash style bath that we've used twice. So it's got all these different things like shampoo, rinse, condition, blow dry. So we're gonna show that it's a bit different. And what I like to do is I actually like to use a tie down to help keep my dog in place. Just makes things a little bit easier for everyone. So we're gonna get this all started up. We are gonna start off, I would like to just get my dog rinsed off first. So we've got our nozzle, and we're gonna get it started. Yes, now what I always like to do is, I like to have treats as we're going along with this. So that way Newport continues to have a nice good time as we are going through and washing. Now, this should have an auto regulation for the temperature, which is always nice for the pups. And as he's continuing to do a good job, I just like to continue to give him treats. Here we go. So let's get him kind of wet down, rinsed off here. There we go. Good boy. Going through. So Newport is about 9 months. And he's really starting to put on some of his growth and weight, which is really nice, because he's always been a little bit smaller of the golden retriever, but he is still doing really, really well. I'm trying my best right now not to get it in his eyes. He doesn't like it too much yet. And then we always want to be aware of the ears. As best we can, we want to limit how much water is getting into the ears. Just because, you know, I mean, you're going to certainly increase the chance of having an ear infection if a whole bunch of water is getting in and you're not able to get it all out. So he is nice and wetted down. So we're going to switch this on over to shampoo. And we're going to kind of maybe hear it in the background, but it's going to be pumping out the shampoo here. Many times I actually like to use my own shampoo just because I don't actually know what's in this, but for the demonstration and the novelty of it, we're going to be using shampoo from this machine. So I like to go through and I really like to just kind of really get into the fur here and get, because goldens have double coats. And so what that's going to do is it's certainly going to help insulate them and keep them warm, because they are working dogs. That means they're going to be out in the field. Many, many people love to use these dogs for field work, which means that they are going into lakes and bodies of water. And that double coat helps them stay warm. So you got to get down past that double coat. Now, here is so with that double coat, you have a double-edged sword, because you really need to make sure, as I'll discuss later on, that you're getting all of your dog dried up, because if you don't, that's when you can start having problems. So we're gonna get his undercarriage here. Excuse me, sir. Get him nice and soaked up. Front here as well. Make sure to get the paws too. Now, this is something that I always, one of the reasons why I like working with the dog's paws a lot. So then when I'm going through and washing the dog's paws, they're comfortable with it. You're not having something that you're fighting with. And get this back side here. Oh boy, someone's gonna be getting some treats. Yeah, go get all that dust off.
He's a bit of a duster going on here.
Yeah, good boy. There we go. Get the top of the head here, just a little bit. I like to keep it away from the eyes. And then with my hands, we'll get the muzzle. Oh, there we go. There we go. Oh, all right, so we're working fast here. We're gonna rinse this off. Kind of noticing that Newport is getting a little bit cold. So, you know, we're wanting to be efficient here. I don't want to keep him wet and chilly, because that's just not fun. No one likes that. So we're going to go through and really use your hands here to get in under this coat. And get everything through here. There we go. You can even put the nozzle right under the skin there, if you'd like. Now, a couple of things to help your dog have kind of a more relaxed and enjoyable bath is I would, if you're using, maybe if you have a dog wash station in your home or your apartment, or even if you're using a tub, I would really recommend just playing around in that tub. Not necessarily playing, but having your dog go in the tub a few handful of times and giving some treats, letting them know that it's nothing to be really that concerned about. That way when you begin the actual process of washing and giving your dog a bath, they're not as concerned. It's not a brand new experience for them. And that way you can focus on really getting through and getting your dog cleaned up, which is ultimately what we're wanting to do here. Another thing that can really help is keeping your dog's nails short. Many bathtubs are slippery for dogs. They don't really, you know, enjoy sliding around. We're gonna go on and start conditioning here. Yeah, I know, but we're getting through it. What you can also do is you can get a mat for your dog, so then they are able to be a little bit more stable. They're not sliding around because they are not going to enjoy not feeling stable in something like that. So that's something to keep in mind there, okay? Now we're using a conditioner from this machine, but what I actually really recommend and I like to do is I like to use a vinegar rinse on my dog. That's a disinfectant, gets rid of yeast, bacteria, and it makes their coats really, really soft. So when you get to snuggle them later on, they're like extra soft. All right, we're gonna go through and let's rinse, and then we're gonna start doing the blow drying after that. Now, I'm only gonna do kind of a half blow dry when we get to that step. I actually like to just use an actual blow dryer, hair blow dryer, to get my dog all dried off. But I'll also use a towel as well. We're just getting all this. I'm gonna hang up, turn that off. We're gonna start the blow dryer. Oh, yes. And we're just gonna whip a lot of this water off of him. Now again, I want to be quick on this because he is gonna be cold. I want to be aware of that. I don't want him sitting all cold. And if he's gonna shake out, I want to step back. There we go. Yeah, good boy, Newport. Now, if your dog isn't really handling their bath as well as Newport is here, you can always use something like a tie-in to really help keep them stabilized in one spot. That's what I've got Newport on, just to kind of help keep them in the same spot here. I'm getting the undercoat by going up here. Really want to get all this water split off at first. I'm not spraying myself for this, okay? And it looks like we may actually have a clog in this thing. see that Newport is still not completely dry, so we want to be aware of this. Now, I'm going to use this towel to keep drying them off, and then once we get back up to our place, I am going to use a blow dryer to get him all the way fluffed up and dry. Because again, I want to make sure that he is not damp on the skin or on that second coat of his, because he can get something like pneumonia, or he can just get sick, and that's, I mean, it's kind of crummy to be wet and cold, right? I'm sure we all have been that way. I'll let him do his little shake and bake. There we go. Now, earlier I talked about making sure that you try to limit the amount of water getting on the ears, because you don't want it to go down into their canals, because then you're getting into the area of having to worry about ear infections. So make sure as you're drying your dog off that you're really getting that ear flap and the leather dried off, okay? Now, I'm not saying that you gotta stick your finger in there with a cotton ball by any means, but I just really, really recommend making sure that your dog's ears are dried off. Let's get this rump and the tail. Yeah. And Newport is helping out because he is just a helper. And there we go. Now, a couple of other things that we're gonna be doing with Newport. I mentioned several times that we're gonna be blow drying them, but I'm also gonna be cutting your nails. After your dog is done with their bath, usually their nails are a little bit softer, just for easier, and then I'm gonna brush them. After a bath, many times their coat gets a little loose, we'll say, and ready to fluff your place up. So I like to be preemptive, and I like to brush them out and get him all looking slick for the neighborhood. All right, here we go. Here was Newport having a bath, did an awesome job. We're gonna finish up and we'll see you all in another video. I'm Dr. Emerald with Working Canine Club. If you gain value from watching this video with Newport and I, make sure to hit the subscribe and notification bell below so you can keep up to date with all of our videos. See you later.